Isang mapagpalang gabi po sa inyong lahat. Good evening, everyone. This is Brother Jonas. Yes, I'm still alive and kicking. And this is for our Lockdown to Look Up series, your daily inspiration amid the COVID-19, day 395. 395 days of being together. Thank you so much for being here. I know that you're learning a lot of things. I know that you are also blessed. Of course, I claim that. And the most important thing that we are doing every night is that we are encountering God. We're experiencing the Lord. We're honoring God every single day. And I hope that you are blessed every night. You know, it's a productive day for me. Today is actually the third day of our book writing workshop. And also, I was also invited a while ago with I Speak. This is a beautiful platform where I was able to share some inspiration to those who are longing for, you know, for some inspiration, those who are living in poverty and they want to experience or live a life of prosperity. That's just so amazing. Thank you so much for being here. Our topic for tonight is all about blessings from your painful past. And this is one of my realizations a while ago that a lot of bad things had happened in my life. And during those moments, I actually despised those experiences. And I'm very grateful because it happened. You know, it sounds crazy. Like, oh my gosh. During those moments, I hated it. I hated my life. I hated my experiences. But now that I'm, you know, I started to inspire, motivate, and bless people, I'm just so happy because God is so good, because God used those painful experiences for me to bless and inspire other people. And we will have our fair share of difficulties in our lives. We will all have our fair share of pain. We will all have our fair share of disappointments. It is bound to happen. Don't live a life running away from problems. Don't live a life wishing that you don't have any problems. Yeah, but pray that God will give you strength. Pray that God will make you stronger every single day. Pray that God will give you the courage. Pray that God will give you the wisdom in order for you to live, to overcome, to blend with your painful experiences, to blend with your struggles. Because literally speaking, I want to be blunt. To be honest, we can never run away from our problems. It is bound to happen. Your painful past bound to happen. It happened because there is a purpose. And I'll be sharing with you a lot of information, a lot of wisdom from our painful past. You know what? I was born and raised in a poor family. Number two, I messed up in a lot of businesses. Yeah, I had my first ever business. It's a photocopier machine, secondhand machine. I loaned for 2 years maybe to pay that loan. And after just 1 week, it didn't work. And my business partner also disappeared from this world. I don't know where she went, but I was left alone paying that loan. Yeah, alone paying the loan. And a series of businesses. I was scammed plenty of times. When I was working overseas, I think I lost around maybe almost $1 million in the businesses that I started, and it all failed. But I'm still here. And of course, the worst is my relationship. This related to relationship, this is one of the painful past that I was really crippled. I was broken down defeated. It's difficult for me to start. It's difficult for me to stand. It's difficult for me to stand. It's difficult for me to start all over again because of problems in relationship. And maybe some of you here, you had struggles in your relationship, you have problems in your relationship. I'm telling you, there's a blessing behind those painful experiences. Another thing is, when I pursued my dreams, there are so many closed doors. Okay, it's difficult. You know what? I remember crying every night, every time I failed in my IELTS examination. And it's very painful. Like, I lost my self-confidence, I lost my self-esteem. I started to doubt myself. I started to believe that I am not good because of those painful experiences. And also my closed doors. I have so many closed doors. And I know that you have also many closed doors, big dreams that you want to achieve, but God didn't answer your prayers. God actually closed doors. And tonight I'll be sharing the main purpose. There's a blessing behind your pain. I repeat, there is a blessing behind your pain. If you are crying now, yeah, it's difficult to understand. It's difficult to grasp the lessons. But if you are crying now, it's a dark night for you. You are suffocated in your life. You don't know how to start. You really despise your experiences, despise your life. It also even came to a point that you no longer want to live. If you are that person, I'm telling you, there's a blessings, okay? Real failures in life are those that we do not take the chance to come back, to have a comeback. Those we do not have the chance to stand back up and then to start all over again. If you fail, please, master some strength to stand back up. Master some strength to do good again, because failure should not be the end of our lives. We fail because it's bound to happen. We will experience pain because it is bound to happen. Okay? If you are going through a lot of things, please know that there is a blessing behind your problems. Amen? I want to share with you our big message for tonight. It's this, okay? Our big message for tonight, one thing that you should remember, it is painful. Your past, it is painful, but it is bound to happen. God allowed that to happen, and it put colors in your life. It brought you to your destiny. You know, I read manuscript every single day. I'm reading books. Whenever I'm not into coaching, I'm not doing this live, I'm actually soaking myself in the first draft in the books of my students. I'm reading it. I'm trying my best to check the content. I try my best to edit. And you know what? Most of them, they experience being molested. There are some who experience being a battered wife, a battered child. Most of them really had a difficult childhood and experienced the worst form of violence, which is poverty. But all these things, all those difficult things are bound to happen. They failed plenty of times in their examination. They failed plenty of times in their business ventures. But you know what? Again, it is bound to happen. Those painful experiences, they are bound to happen. And it made who you are. Without those painful experiences, you will never become the person that you are today. You will never become the best version of yourselves. That's why don't despise your past. Don't, fight with your past. Don't just think that nothing good your past had brought in your life. Actually, there are blessings. Amen. And I want to share with you our Bible verse for tonight, but let's pray a favorite prayer here. This is so beautiful. It's a prayer created by Brother Bo Sanchez. I hope and pray that this will become your testimony. This will become your declaration every single day. Can I request everyone to close your eyes and feel the presence of the Lord in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Today, I receive all of God's love for me. Today, I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today, I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today, I open myself to God's word so that I become more like Jesus every day. Today, I proclaim that I am God's beloved, I am God's servant, I am God's powerful champion, and because I am blessed, I am blessing the world in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. To God be the glory. I pray that God will pour out his blessings to you right this very moment. I know that God is working behind the scene. Get ready for it, because you are bound to become successful. Amen. Our Bible verse for tonight is from the book of Isaiah chapter 43 verse 18. Whenever I talk about the past, this is my Bible verse. It says, forget the former things and do not dwell on the past. Whatever you do, you can never undo your past. You can never change it. Okay? It happened already. And there's nothing we can do. Reality will say that we can never undo our past. If we will dwell on our past, we can never move forward. Especially if you are carrying a lot of baggages. For God's sake, forgive yourself. Forgive those people who hurt you. Forgive also, anyone. Like, there are times, I remember attending one of the holy masses presided by Father Jerry. He even said, forgive God. See? We are human beings. We don't have any right to do that. But somehow, sometimes we are angry. Sometimes we feel that God doesn't love us, yeah? But I pray, this is my prayer to all of you, forget what had happened in your past. If it made you cry, there are some things that you should take, the blessings, okay, which I'll be sharing now. Forget the former things, do not dwell on the past. Five things for tonight. Number one is this, okay? Number one, okay? The first thing for tonight, the blessings, okay, from your painful past is this. This is beautiful. You were refined and you were honed. Remember, like they cannot form the gold, they cannot form without trying to put some force, some effort, even diamonds, you know, they need, even seeds will not grow if they will not stay in the darkness. That's it. You develop, okay? You improve a lot in your life because of your experiences. People who are so strong right now, they went through hell. Yeah? People who experience so many problems in their lives, these are the strongest people because they develop their life's muscles. That's it. You develop your life's muscles because of your difficulties, because of your painful experiences. God is honing you. God is refining you. God is trying to bring out the best in you. God is trying to build the muscles in your life because God knows that along the way, He will never clear. Like, that's not His power. God's power will not rest, or God's power is not about removing all the obstacles. God's power is all about giving you the strength, the courage, the wisdom, the guidance to go through that obstacles, to overcome the obstacles, to win the obstacle, to finish the race. That's the main, you know, that you can experience the fullness of the Lord, the power of the Lord, the power of God by not Him not removing your problems, but Him giving you the strength, Him giving you the power, Him giving you the courage, Him giving you the wisdom. Amen. You were refined and honed because of your past experiences. Just trying to look back. Just trying to look back with your painful experiences. It helped you to become the best version of yourselves. Your painful past, one of the biggest blessings that you can get from it are actually this, your character. It really built you to become a stronger version of yourselves. Amen? That's number one for tonight. Number two is this, you were, okay? Another blessing is this. Another blessing from your painful past is that God directed you towards your dreams. God directed you towards your dreams. Sometimes our most painful experiences, it talks about our closed doors. Sometimes, okay, it's all about our unanswered prayers. And it's really painful, been there. I told you the moment in my life where I felt suicidal, the moment in my life where I was so broken down, defeated, it's because of the unanswered prayers. And I'm so grateful because God actually will put some detour. God will actually, you know, try to remove some events in your life. God will bring a lot of opportunities so that God will direct you towards your dreams. It's difficult to understand, but maybe one reason why people were removed in your life, the main purpose why opportunities or your dreams, okay, or breakthroughs were not given to you, because maybe God is directing it to something bigger. God is directing it to something amazing. God is directing it to something that can really bless so many people. Maybe your dreams, maybe the things that you want to do, it's based on what you want to happen in your life. But see, God is always the final say. God is the final say in your life. It's painful, okay? I cried when I was not given the opportunity to work in Canada. You know, it's a painful past for me. Flunking in my exam for almost, oh my gosh, almost six times. Okay, not passing the IELTS examination. It pained me every time I fail. I really despised the. Like, it's really painful. Like, it's difficult to manage. Maybe it took me around 2 weeks to process. You know, I'm so weak and I was so frustrated in life. But you know, it happened. My painful experiences from my past, God used that in order for him to bring me to the opportunities and to the dreams and to the destiny that belongs to me. God will do that in your life so that he can bring you to your destiny, so that God can bring you to the opportunities that you deserve, so that God can bring you to the rightful dreams waiting for you. Please, okay? Again, I repeat, your painful past directed you towards your dreams. That's number two for tonight. Number three is this. You were saved from your, this one. Blessings from the past. Another one is this. Beautiful. You were saved from the worst case scenario. Maybe an accident will happen, or maybe you will become worse when God will answer your prayer. Maybe your past, you know, your painful past, because God is saving you from the wrong relationship. Maybe God is saving you from wrong group of friends. Maybe God was saving you from the wrong place. I remember one sharing, there is a man who's walking and his shoe lace was removed. And she was irritated because she needed to stop and stoop down and fix it. While he was fixing, something went down. Okay, if he did not stop, maybe he became a victim of accident. And that's it in our lives. Sometimes God will allow us to stay. Sometimes God will allow us to stand still for our protection. Don't always think that, oh my gosh, my precious love life, this love life that I nurtured for so many years and I wanted it. You know, this is only the one thing that could make me happy. But you know what? Little did you know, okay, that maybe God saved you from worst case scenario. Maybe God really saved you from the worst thing that can happen in your life. I love this realization. And I'm really grateful because I know that if I am not here, imagine, huh? When I went home, I arrived in the Philippines on December 27, 2019. COVID-19 started December 29 in China. So if I was still working in the Sultanate of Oman and there's this COVID and so many problems will arise and I didn't have any opportunity to start my writer legacy, my foundation, and so many businesses that I started, if I'm still trapped in the Sultanate of Oman, God save me from the worst case scenario that can happen to me. Amen. That's number three for tonight. Number four is this. You were brought the people who truly love you. Sometimes, you know, our blessings, will come from our most difficult circumstances. And through our most painful circumstances, God will actually bring us, okay? God will actually bring us to the right people, people who value us, people who truly love us. And I'm also expert in losing a lot of people. To tell you honestly, I kept on losing people in my life. And it's okay. It's okay. I'm not a beggar. I don't beg for someone to stay. If they didn't like me, if they didn't like me, it's all right with me. There are still people who love me. There are still people who value me. I have my family. I have my trusted friends, and it's fine with me. But I'll tell you honestly, in the past 2 years, kept on losing people whom I value, people whom I protected, people whom I trusted, and they started leaving. And you know what? The good news, even if they left me, I'm still going through with it. I'm still going through with my dreams. I was not shaken. And I'm still going through with what I want in my life. And I think that's also another discipline. I am grateful because the most painful experiences I had with regard to my relationship brought me to the right people who truly love, respect, supported, and value me. God remove those people in your life because God is bringing you to the right people who will truly love you, who will truly respect, who will truly take care of you. Amen? There's a blessing from your painful past. And of course, the most important thing is this. Number five is this. You were rescued by God. I want to share one story. You know what? I had a friend before in the Sultanate of Oman. When everything is worse, when everything is good, when everything is okay, you will never see her in the church. You will never see her. She enjoys her life and live life to the fullest, but during her darkest moment, you will see her every Sunday. You will see her going to the church. And you know, sometimes our painful past will rekindle our faith. There were times in my life when I forget a lot of things, especially with regard to my relationship with the Lord. Before, I was so busy with my dreams. I was so busy building my dreams, and I forgot the Lord. And you know what? He is amazing because He really can make ways in order for us to go back to Him. And sometimes, your painful past, okay, it happened. The things that make you cry, it happened because God made His rescue. You were saved by God, okay? God rescued you because you are already wandering. Your faith is already, like nothing is growing in your life. You are already losing your faith. You're already drifting from your dreams, and God will go there, take you, and bring you to your right place. Remove your past, you know, allowed you to bleed, allowed you to experience allowed you to experience your rock bottom. God can do that because it's actually a rescue. It's so good, yeah, realizing that our painful experiences is actually God's rescue. Our most disappointing moments are actually God's rescue. I'm just so grateful. Praise God. To God be the glory. Five things for tonight. The blessings from your painful fast. Number one, you were refined and honed. Number two, you were directed to your dreams. Number three, you were saved from the worst case scenario. Number four, you were brought to the people who truly love you. And number five, you were rescued by God. Can I pray for you? Can I request everyone to close your eyes and feel the presence of the Lord in the name of the Father and of the Son of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our dear and ever-loving God, we just want to honor you tonight. Thank you, God, for everything. Thank you, Lord God, for the wonderful works that you are doing in our lives. We just want to honor you and recognize you. Lord, it's all because of you. It's all because of your grace. And we thank you, Lord God, for everything. And thank you, Lord God, for your big message tonight that we should not despise our painful experiences, our painful past, because there are blessings. Thank you, Lord God, for reminding us that you are still in control. Whatever it is that is, whatever is going through in our lives, you are there. Thank you, God, for everything. And Lord, I lift to you every person now. Embrace them, Lord, especially those who are watching now, going through something, going through some difficult moments in their lives. I pray, Lord God, that you bless these people. I pray, Lord God, that you guide these people. I pray, Lord God, that you send the Holy Spirit so that these people will still enjoy their journey despite their disappointments, despite their struggles, despite their difficulties. And Lord, I offer a special prayer to those who are suffering from mental health crisis. I believe that you're bigger than depression. I believe that you're bigger than panic anxiety attacks. I believe that you're bigger than their suicidal ideation. In Jesus' name, I declare healing to anyone watching now. I speak healing to anyone watching now experiencing mental health crisis. Lord, I lift to you the families of these people. You know how much they love their families. Continue to bless their parents, their spouse, their siblings, their children. Lord, I pray that you will become the center of the relationship, that they will worship you as one family. Thank you, God, for everything. Lord, you offer a special prayer to family members who are far away from each other. Continue to bless them, Lord God. And Lord, I declare also healing to anyone who is sick right now, watching right this very moment, who is sick, afflicted with the COVID-19, having cancer, going through a lot of physical health problems and mental and emotional and spiritual health problems. In Jesus' name, we claim healing. And we extend prayers, Lord, to their family members who are sick right now in the hospitals, in the ICU, afflicted with the COVID-19, having chronic disease. Lord God, in Jesus' name, we declare healing. Lord, I also lift to you the health of these people. I also declare, Lord God, the finances of these people. I pray for financial breakthroughs. I believe that you're a God of prosperity. I believe that you're a God of abundance. In Jesus' name, we believe that you will provide. Lord, I offer to you their work, what they are doing every single day. Continue to bless these people, Lord God. Use them for your greater glory. I pray for breakthroughs in their workplaces. I pray for harmony. I pray for more blessings. I pray for promotion even, Lord God. And keep them safe, Lord God, in their workplaces. Lord, I lift the dreams of these people, whatever dreams inside their hearts. Maybe to work overseas. Maybe to go back home in the Philippines for good. Maybe to write a book. Maybe to build a church. Maybe to start a family. Maybe for a childless couple to have a baby. Maybe to start a postgrad studies, maybe to be promoted, whatever dreams, purify it, Lord God. Make it holy. And we know that in your most perfect time, their dreams will come true. Lord God, we offer a special prayer for this pandemic. We're excited that one day this world, this earth will become COVID-free. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. And lastly, Lord God, we just want to storm the heaven with praises and thanksgiving. Thank you so much for the gift of life. We are so much grateful that you have given us the opportunity to live. And we pray that you give us more years so that we can serve our purpose. Tonight, Lord God, we just want to bring back to you all the glory and honor to the most powerful name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. In the name of the Father and of the Son of the Holy Spirit. Amen. To God be the greatest glory. Sana ulanin kayong lahat ng walang katapusang biyaya at pagpapala. Maraming salamat po sa lahat ng nanood sa gabing ito. Thank you so much, Author Geraldine, Pastora Ami, salamat. Author MJ, Nanay Ninita, Harry Cortez, Rica Mabayad, Author Caroline, Author Mylene, and Sir Joey, maraming salamat Sabi ni Julius Martinez, a blessed evening to everyone. Thank you. He's the author of Surviving the Sandstorm of My Life. Kenneth Maliari is also watching, the author of Rob Childhood. Deeply appreciated, Kate. And of course, our boss idol, rank one sa puso nating lahat, si Sir Joey De Leon. God is the greatest healer. Pray, move on, and allow God to cure us. Thank you, Coach Idol, Brother Jonas Dupo. Maraming salamat, Sir, rank one sa aming mga puso, Sir Joey De Leon. Maraming salamat. Julius Martinez, sabi, like the process of becoming a beautiful butterfly, kailangan nating dumaan sa madilim muna bago ma-achieve ang mga breakthroughs na yan. And of course, author Ronald Bacani, the author of Pisara, is watching. Good evening, Coach. Maraming salamat sa testimonial mo kay author Bethel Zipagan sa kanyang aklat. Okay, thank you so much. Deeply appreciated. And of course, Harry Cortez is also watching. Good evening, Coach. I'm back. You are always welcome. Our author from Pangasinan. Maraming salamat, author Harry Cortez. Pagpalain ka pa. Former things are gone, the new has come. Sabi ni Julius, it's beautiful Bible verse. Thank you po sa lahat. And of course, yeah, author MJ, deeply appreciated. Maraming salamat. Okay, thank you so much for tuning in. And of course, ang aking kaibigan, si Pastora Ami, my good friend. Alam mo ba, si author Joseph na kaibigan mo ay isa ng author. Isa ng, ay nako, si author, pangalan ang whole name ni author Joseph. Ami, Joseph Ramos. Enrolled. He's now part of Write Your Legacy. That's because of you. Maraming salamat. Yun lamang po. Matulog na kayong lahat. Good night, everyone. Magpahinga na. And be grateful before you sleep tonight. Please do pray. And also, please be grateful. Offer gratitude habang nakahiga ka na. Kalimutan mo muna lahat ng mga problema. Isipin mo muna lahat ng mga biyaya mo. To God be the glory. Thank you so much for the love, trust, and support. I'm forever grateful. And let's nourish our spirit and join hands in prayer that this pandemic will soon end. To God be the greatest glory. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Bye-bye. Thank you.